Hello, and welcome back to Popful Mail Redux. Are you as anxious as mail is to get started? I know I am. Apparently that's how you're supposed to pronounce that word, redux. Sounds like ducks, accent on the second syllable. Which I didn't know. You learn something new. And this is episode 2. We just had our first boss fight, which I think went pretty well. And our first encounter with Tat, the magician, who will later on become a playable character. And we made our way through the Elf Village successfully, and now onto Tree Sun. This is where it starts getting a little bit more difficult, so I will keep up my prodigious save habits. Not difficult, really. You just have to be more careful. The enemies are a little bit faster and less predictable. You have a few more hazards, like those spinning spiky gears down there. And of course you have a few badgers. Just plain old dumb ordinary badgers. Well, I shouldn't say dumb. I mean, they do kind of just walk into your sword, but maybe that's just how they were raised. They were brought up to just walk into your sword instead of fighting back. Certain projectiles can be blocked by ducking and bringing your shield out. I don't think you actually have to have a shield in your inventory to do that. It's just kind of always there. And the other characters have an equivalent. Tat just pulls his cape out. And the third character, well, you haven't even met him yet in the previous playthrough, so I will try to keep that as spoiler-free as possible. The third character is my favorite, though. If you played the game before, you know what I'm talking about. Or, you know, looked at the title screen, because he's there as well. But I don't think I've actually shown the title screen that has him. It's on the, when you continue, it takes you back to the title screen that has Male Tat and a mystery character number 3. I should have gone. Oh well, better safe than sorry. Oops. Don't zap me. It's very rude. I mean, I know I go around zapping people once I get the ability to zap, but you know, that's different. You guys are the bad guys. You can tell you're the bad guys because, I don't know. I mean, I walk into you and it hurts me. I guess that proves you're bad. I'm not sure why it happens. It's just kind of, an effect. Whoa, shit. If you just kind of stand still and let those guys walk towards you, they never actually get close enough to attack. But if you walk towards them, then you get into striking distance.
Hey, is someone out there? Please help me! The wizards above are guarding the key to my cell. Can you get it?
Sorry, can't get involved unless there's something in it for me.
What? Oh, okay. Listen, help me out of here and I'll make it worth your while.
Okay, now you're talking my language. How much?
Let me think. How about 200 gold?
200 gold? Yeah. I guess you don't want to be rescued too badly. I might consider it for, say, 700 gold or so.
700 gold? Man, I don't have that much. But if you'll consider 500 gold, we have a deal.
Fair enough. Consider yourself a free man.
Yeah, 500 gold's not bad. I'm not sure if this is considered a boss or not. Let me save again just to be on the safe side. These wizards are a lot tougher than the other wizards you encounter. So I'm going to have to take this a little bit more carefully. I don't want to get too many wizards on the screen at once, which is what I'm about to do. Damn it. I think I might have screwed this up. Oh man. If you get a bunch on the screen, yeah, use my elixir, and I don't want to let that happen. So I will retry that. Excuse me. See, this is good, because I kind of kited one of them over toward me. I drew aggro from him, while all the others were still headed in the opposite direction. See if I can do that again. Nah, probably not. See, when you have... Oops. When you have that many projectiles flying at you, you just, you don't have an opportunity to attack. Now, if I had her next weapon, then this would be a piece of cake. Because I could cheese the hell out of them. Alright, well, let's wait until they turn around, and then see if I can, get them one at a time. I'll wait until the other two are off the screen. Oh, well, didn't work out exactly how I wanted, but this should still be okay. All those hit points and they don't even drop any gold. Yeah, that's not a boss. Which sucks because I was hoping to get healed. Oh, the switch won't budge. Anything over here? Nope. Ah, there we go. Oh, yeah, it's that guy.
Mail? It's you! And you got the key! Whoa, how in the world did you get past the wizards?
Doesn't matter. You're free. So fork over the 500 gold.
Jeez, no time for pleasantries, huh? Follow me to the village, and I'll pay you there.
I thought you had the cash on you. This better not be a trick.
No tricks. I just don't carry 400 gold on me.
Oh, no you don't! We agreed on 600!
600 gold? Are you insane? I know it was 500!
Okay, sissy boy. 500. Hand it over.
Like I said, at the village.
Just goes to show, you can't trust elves. I apologize. I don't mean to be racially insensitive. But seriously, fuck elves.
I don't know how to thank you properly, Mail, but I'm sure this will help.
Oh yeah, that does help.
Say, I heard that the Gingerbread Grifter Gang and Muttonhead are working together. Don't know if it's true, but it makes sense. That's the second time I've heard that. I'll stay here to defend my village. Hopefully you'll find Muttonhead and put a stop to his crazy shenanigans. The ladder to the right will lead you out of here. Good luck, Mail.
Well, okay, maybe elves aren't that bad after all. I mean, he did give me the agreed upon 500 gold. Although he did try to cheat me out of it. Wait, where's the village? I definitely want to stop at the village before I go on to the Golden Tower. Because the golem is kind of a pain in the ass.
I just can't believe it! My wedding ring was stolen by the Badger Gang! Badger Gang? Yes! They're ruthless criminals with a hideout near here! Oh, I just don't know how I'm going to break this news to my husband! Oh! Maybe you won't have to.
Yeah, remember that weird area in the elf village that didn't have anything there? That's where her wedding ring is. Let's heal up. Let's buy, let's see. Let's save back 500 so I can... Well, I don't know. Is there a weapon store in this village? I don't think there is. I think it might just be the fruit store. I don't know. Oops. Great. Let's go back and spend another 5 gold. I like the fact that the currency in this game is just gold. They didn't feel the need to make up any special fantasy currency. Alright, let's see what you have. Dagger, okay. I was kind of hoping that the next weapon would be available, but I guess that's not for a while. Alright, let's go ahead and buy the leather armor. And we don't have anything to sell, I don't think. Yeah. Equip that puppy. And let's buy a couple apples just for good measure. We're probably okay, but I like to be prepared. So yeah, we're not going back to that side quest yet, because the boss there is a little tough. And I'd like to wait until we have the weapon after the next one. Man, 180. Oh, you don't even have apples, just oranges and cherries. I think oranges heal 20. Oh yeah. Heal me up this last 5. I think oranges are 20 and cherries are 40 or something like that. I should be okay. Apples are 60 and the bananas, the best ones, are 80. Alright, well, let's get on with it. I think we have one more boss. Well, one boss before the golem. Am I going the right way? I don't think so. I think I need to go up. The golem is my least favorite boss in the game. Like, I remember playing last time, thinking, oh man, these bosses suck, but at least they're not as bad as the golem. And in my playthrough, the 14 videos, I managed to do it, but in subsequent tries, damn it! In subsequent tries, I had a little bit of trouble with the golem. I should probably go back and heal, but I should be okay. Let's save just to be sure, though. You know, you think, in a world with an infinite supply of wood, there wouldn't be so much conflict. Since you have infinite, you know, infinite fuel for fire, infinite paper supplies, infinite, you know, any infinite resource is going to make a pretty utopian society. Since you have these infinite wood generators, just make everything out of wood. Which it looks like that's what they did. Well, except for the outside here is like a weird stone pattern. Oh, damn it, why did I do that? The trick to beating enemies in this game is to walk up next to them and keep hitting them until they die. It's not much of a trick, but it works. Now, I have played this recently, but I'm still not 100% sure as to the boss order. Pretty sure the next thing is like a worse version of the Mad Bomber. Which sucks, but it's not as bad as the Golem. Nothing's as bad as the Golem. Come on, there you go. Those bees aren't even worth trying to kill. I don't know why the spiders seem to be the only enemy that drops that herb that heals you for 5 hit points. None of the other enemies seem to do that. It'd be kind of nice if it did. So, for those of you who haven't been following anything in the last several months, I had a dental problem that was preventing me from talking. It gave me a speech impediment. And I still think my voice sounds a little funky, but most people say they can't hear much of a difference. Oh shit. Damn it! So I went on ahead and got back into recording and streaming. I'm going to try to stream at least once a week, in addition to uploading the Popful Mail videos. Aw, man. That was bullshit. The logs were... Ugh. Oh, my God. If you're watching this in real time, then the next stream on my Twitch.tv account will be, Borderlands 2 with Just Dropping More Draconis. I'm also streaming, Might and Magic Clash of Heroes, which I like a lot. It is one of my favorite games that I've played recently. Ah, man, we have so few hit points. I kind of want to pop a healing item just to... Yeah, you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to use this orange that I'm probably not going to use any other time. This might be the boss. I think this is the boss. This boss sucks. I'm not going to lie. The strategy is to stay close to him, because he won't drop bombs as long as you're close to him. All you have to do is jump when he does that little stomp attack. Otherwise, you take damage. Not much damage. That only did 5 to me, but oh god. Oh god, I'm boned. Oh man. I forgot it still damages you, even when you're on the ladder. Okay. Well, that almost went well. Take 2. So yeah, I tried streaming on YouTube, since they're allowing anyone with over 1,000 subscribers to do live streams. Oh shit. And it kinda sucks. So I'm still at Twitch for the moment. I don't like the ads, but at least the chat room seems to be working again, for the most part. That's what happens if you don't stay close to him. He fires bombs, which are much worse than the stomp attack. They do like 20 points of damage. Actually, when this video goes up, I think, Borderlands 2 will have already transpired. But, tune in Thursday for a stream of Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. And that'll do it for Popful Mail. Tune in tomorrow for yet another episode. I'm Duke of the Bump, and I will see you later.